So the primary drivers of cancer costs in Ontario are quite a few. One is, for example, the rising incidence of cancer cases, so the number of new cases diagnosed each year, as well new treatments, so more sophisticated treatments that are related to, for example, chemotherapy drugs. The cost of chemotherapy drugs is on the rise as well. Also, more expensive techniques to undertake surgery, for example. As we found in our work as well, the cost of hospitalizations is actually a large chunk of the cost of cancer care. There's a lack of cancer cost estimates in Canada, and we wanted to replicate some work that had been done in the US. They looked at the 21 most prevalent cancers, and we wanted to do the same thing for Ontario. This information is also really important for decision makers. It provides them with a basis to make decisions, for example, around resource allocation within the healthcare system, but also to figure out, you know, where are the priorities in terms of where should we invest money in terms of screening or other interventions, for example. So in order to write the paper, to do the report, we used data from the Institute for Clinical Evaluative Sciences, and we linked it to data from Cancer Care Ontario to get information on the treatment. So we selected all patients in Ontario diagnosed from 1997 to 2007 with one of the 21 most prevalent cancer sites. So the phase of care approach is basically an incidence-based method to assign patients time to different phases of care. So as many of us know, there are very high costs after diagnosis because of all the work that's involved with ascertaining the patient's cancer diagnosis and then just treating them as soon as possible. But there's also very high costs just before the patient dies, and that's usually has to do with palliative care. Sometimes the patient is also hospitalized just before they die. So there's very high costs in those two phases, and that was one way to sort of conceptualize how we wanted to define and how we wanted to estimate the cost of care for cancer. So our key findings were that the cost of cancer care varied by cancer. They also varied by phase of care. They also varied by time horizon. So what we found was that costs were very high shortly after diagnosis and very high just before the patient died. And this was in line with work that was also found in the US. We also found that cancers with very short survival had high costs in the initial phase of care. So we're talking about cancer, esophageal cancer, pancreatic cancer. And then we also found that, for example, for costs over the lifetime, costs were higher for hematological cancers, or otherwise known as blood cancers. So we're talking about multiple myeloma, leukemia, lymphoma. So we looked at the cost estimates for the entire Ontario population, and once we look at this at the population level, we find that costs with breast cancer, prostate, colorectal, and lung are the cancers with the highest overall total burden of care. But we also saw that the overall total burden of care for lymphoma and leukemia is actually relatively high too, and that's due to the high numbers as well, but also the high cost with these cancers over the lifetime. For lifetime costs for leukemia, multiple myeloma, and lymphoma, we were looking at costs in the range of $100,000. But that's costs only to the healthcare system. So those are costs incurred by the Ministry of Health, for example. We didn't look at costs incurred by patients out of pocket or by third-party payers, such as private insurers. So we're really just looking at a slice of the pie. One of the cancer sites we looked at was colorectal cancer, and we estimated obviously the cost for a patient's lifetime, and we found that those costs were actually higher in Ontario than other studies in the US. And we believe that's probably most likely due to the fact that we also included younger patients who tend to be treated more aggressively, while other studies in the US only looked at patients 65 plus, so patients covered under Medicare. These cost estimates are important for decision makers because they will help decision makers understand how much it costs to treat a given patient with cancer. It will help them figure out the best way to allocate resources, scarce resources, within the healthcare system, within the cancer system, and even among different cancers. And it will help justify screening programs and intervention programs, which can help make the system more efficient. In other words, make the system work better. And that can translate into better outcomes for patients, better care.